not always just about the person. I had a young man say to me once in a workshop, he was put on medication, which was needed at the time, but he didn't feel right inside. There were still things going on for him. And I said, did you talk about it? He said, no, everyone was just happier that I was quieter.
Yes.
And so we reflected on the fact that often that crisis management is about everyone else around the person, including the systems, not feeling as drained, feeling better, feeling more relieved. So when that crisis is over, they're fine, but we have the individual still holding the root cause of their pain.
Absolutely. And I guess what you're introducing is the concept of behaviour issues don't actually belong to just one person. Yeah, they might be exhibited from one person, but those behavioural displays that come from that one person actually belong to a whole society. Yeah, and unless we're going to start taking the societal approach, then again, we're only ever addressing the micro rather than addressing the macro, which is what's needed. But what you've introduced is the concept that the one person presenting with behavioural issues per se is actually the aspect of life that a lot of people around them haven't yet developed the skills to deal with. Yeah, so they themselves are not feeling equipped to deal with that. It's very common, I'll teach in the clinical setting. One of my clients recently observed his mother crying. But as a 13, 14-year-old boy, he was like, well, you could see all he wanted to do was make her better. Yeah, do whatever he could to stop her crying. But in that process, rather than allowing him to stop her from crying, I taught him to understand why mum was crying. It's actually good for mum to cry, and support him to develop the skills so that he feels equipped with the fact that another person's using behaviours that previously he didn't feel equipped to deal with. So as a whole society, schools are not feeling equipped to deal with increased behavioural challenges, prisons are not feeling equipped, mental health facilities are not feeling equipped to deal with that. So the management strategies are ones that are looking like they offer society a relief at that time. But we need to understand it is a whole societal approach of a lot of people being presented with life that they're not feeling equipped to deal with.
Hence the behaviour.
Yeah, correct. So the behaviours from one person are the behaviour are a reaction to the parts of life, but that behaviour becomes the challenging parts of life for all those in their immediate environment. And it's just to say they themselves haven't yet developed the skills. So they then start exhibiting their own unwanted behaviours.
You can see the chain effects.
Yeah, it becomes a vicious cycle. Just keep going round and round. And when I go round and round, it actually starts spiralling as well. So the intensity starts increasing. Because if I'm working, let's say, with one person in a family, very, very rarely do I work with one person in the family. It's actually a whole family approach. If I'm working with one person in a classroom, I try to make it about the whole classroom. If I'm working with one person in the workplace, it's about the whole workplace, because everybody's behaviours impact on everybody. Mm-hmm.